Thank you. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the University of Peradeniya Science Alumni Association, UPSA, I would like to thank you all for being here today for the 11th Annual General Meeting. To begin with the proceedings formally, please rise for the national anthem, followed by the faculty anthem.
Sri Lanka, Namo 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 Mata.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now to welcome the gathering, I cordially invite the president of the University of Peradeniya Science Alumni Association, Professor Swarna Vimalasiri, to deliver a welcome address.
Good evening, everyone. Professor Saluk Podithuakku, the Dean of the Faculty and Parent of the Science Alumni Association, Founder President Professor Vijay Kumar and Madam Kumar, Immediate Past President Professor Bandara and Madam Bandara, and Executive Committee members, UPSA members who are joining online. And I wish to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. In this evening, we are having our AGM with a limited number of participants on ground due to the prevailing situation. And I thought of sharing few important points at this occasion. And if I... And I will be using a small presentation. Of course, you have seen the beauty of the Faculty of Science and the place in the song that we heard a few minutes ago. And I have placed few slides for you to remind you of the place where you have studied probably many, many years back. And if I talk a few words about the Science Alumni Association, University of Peradeniya Science Alumni Association, in short, we call it UPSA. It was founded on 19th December 2009, next, exactly 11 years back, and as Professor Kumar as the founder president, and the mission of the Science Alumni Association had been we have the mission of association as to communicate with and bring value to the alumni of the Faculty of Science of the University of Peradeniya and to support actively and financially the achievement of the goals of the faculty as detailed in its mission statement. So therefore, we need to look at the mission and the mission statements of the faculty as well. And if we now look at the vision and the mission of the faculty, what it says is the vision is, our vision is to be a globally renowned Faculty of Science, contributing towards the development of a vibrant scientific community. And the mission of the faculty is to promote excellence in education, training, research, outreach activities in the basic and applied sciences and to organize and conduct such programs to support national development. And of course, the faculty is doing it very well. And that is why we have science graduates all over the world at the leading positions. And also, I just had a look at the faculty statistics in comparison to the membership of UPSA. And the recent the statistics that appear on the web is like this. Number of students in a given year, all 4 years, 1,770. And it says total staff is 125, including Professor Emeritus. And number of students graduating each year, I just counted, it's not there, but roughly it's like 450 to 525. And if you look at the year that we have started UPSA and where we are now, and we started in 2009, and after 10 years, if you look at the number, it's like, I mean, number graduated is around 5,000. And the total number of membership is 575. It's really a sad situation. And if you look at the number, that is those who are turning back to see how their alma mater is doing, it's almost negligible in numbers, and so roughly about 10% of the graduates of the faculty. So where are the rest 90% of the graduates? Have they forgotten the faculty, or we need to look at it? So I urge each and every member of the UPSA to bring at least 5 members of your friends so that we can increase the number to 1,000. And all those figures and the things in and around us explain that faculty has done its job. And that's why we are living a life today meeting all our expectations. And now if you look back and ask yourself, have we done our part in return as alumni? And at least to get the membership of UPSA. Say, I mean, even if it's a kind of a bitter thing to speak out, the truth is that people are trying to find excuses for everything. And if you live outside the country, say, I mean, but always what you think about is, how am I going to pay this 1,000 rupees, because I had to pay extra as a transfer fee. But if you look back again, if you want to have a kind of, I mean, transcript, you will get someone who is here, a friend or a relative, to pay that money for you and get your job done. So why it's just a matter of why you can't try to do that for the place where you have studied. And if you analyze this situation very carefully, you will find that it's nothing other than the problem of assigning priorities to different activities in your life. And I suggest you to think about it very carefully, tap your heart and see what the actual problem is. And even if it's like this, I mean, there are a few people who have looked back and looked at the institution where they have studied and helped the faculty. So faculty has received some support in developing the infrastructure, and there was a smart board project, and the canteen was renovated, student canteen was renovated, and then the digital podium was provided. So likewise, there were support coming from the alumni, and we as UPSA respect those who have supported, and also we extend our appreciation from the association. And if you wish to support the faculty, and how can you do that? I mean, you can support, there are support schemes for undergraduates. You need not to always support them financially. You can always give moral support to them. And also there are laboratory facilities which you can improve. I mean, there are many things that the laboratories are discarding, which can be used in here for many, many years. And you can always, from outside the country, you can hold awareness programs. I mean, you can help our students to know about the higher education opportunities, likewise in and out of what is around you. You can explain those things to the students here. So at the outset, you need to understand none of these are mandatory, but of course, I mean, we all, as citizens of this country, we have a social responsibility to pay back the tax that the poor man has paid for our education. So I expect you to make yourself a wanted child of the faculty. And with that note, I wish to once again welcome you all for the annual general meeting and 11th annual general meeting of the Science Alumni Association. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam. I next warmly invite Professor Saluka Kodithuwakku, Dean of the Faculty of Science, to address the gathering.
Good evening, everybody. Professor Swarna Vimalasiri, the President of the UPSA, Dr. Tanandu Devasurendra, Secretary of the UPSA, and Dr. Priyanga Vijay Singha, treasurer of the UPSA, and all the other executive committee members, and former presidents, including the founder president, and dear colleagues. It is glad to see you are present, either physically or through online, to this 11th annual general meeting of the UPSA. Though during this year, we could not do much due to this pandemic situation, I personally know that the executive committee members work very hard to carry out several activities, but sometimes they could not. And then even I personally know how hard they work on organizing this particular event. There are so many restrictions from the university side and also health in sector, and so many things are there. But still, finally, we as the UPSA, we decided to conduct this particular event in hybrid mode. I mean, those who wish to participate physically, we invited them or we welcomed them, and then the others through the online. And then the other thing regarding what the president already mentioned, as the dean of the faculty, even I am not to say very happy, I am not happy at all when you look at the our membership, 571. It is almost similar to a single intake per faculty at present. Our annual intake is 530, and the next year it will be increased to 650, but that is forced on us. But anyway, and then I personally feel that after 11 years, we could not get the at least 10,000 membership. As the president very correctly mentioned, it is not due to the hard work or commitment of the committee members. I know that they work very hard to get new members to the society, but always there are, you know, excuses from the members. I can still remember, and one of the AGM meetings I recommended to, not to force, but at least to encourage each and every demonstrator to become a member of this particular society. And even at that time, one of the demonstrators had, you know, a different idea what that person asked from the head of the department who requested to join. This person asked, okay, madam, if I join this UPSA, what will I get? What will I get by joining? And in the next year, I address that time in front of the students. But if that is our pupils' attitude, well, that is why we are here with the just 571 members. But I also request all the members, the past members of this Faculty of Science, University of Peradeniya, I request all the graduates to assign the first priority to pay back to your alma mater, not by financial contribution or anything else. The first thing is just become a member of this particular society. And then at least we can be happy. And then over the years, the number of graduates we produce, at least this much of people are interested in this particular society. Then I would like to say a few words about what the president mentioned regarding the contributions made by the science alumni to the development of the faculty. And I must say, a couple of batches financially supported us to improve the digital facilities of the faculty. Then I'm very happy to say that, thanks to that, during this COVID pandemic situation, we deliver our lectures through online. That was a great help. And even I talked to the members of that particular science batch. And then when I passed the message to them, they were very happy. And then they told me that they will see the possibility of supporting more. And not only that, when I mentioned that one of the batch supported us in this way, And they asked me, okay, what else you need? Then I said, these are the things we need. And then they helped us. And then likewise, several batches came forward and helped us. And then thanks to that, we have developed many teaching learning facilities at the faculty, not from the government funds, but from these donations. And therefore, I appreciate those donations, financial donations, but those directly come to me, and then I invest them for the development of the faculty. And in addition to that, some other alumni help students. Some alumni award scholarships, annual scholarships to the what we call students on merit, and the needy students. And then also in addition to that, Science Alumni Association itself, throughout the last 10 years, as I said, I just disregard this year because this year a hard time for everybody. And during the previous 10 years, even the UPSA helped the faculty as well as the SAN students for many ways. In particular, as you know, I think Professor Kumar knows this very well, that sometimes when the students want to go abroad for sport activity or whatever, they directly come to the dean and ask, sir, can you financially help me? And then obviously, deans do not have financial have support given to facilitate those things. And then, as the dean, only thing what I can do is, I directly forward or direct the students to the president of the Science Alumni Association. And then Science Alumni Association help them in financially and many other ways. So that is a great relief for me. Then the otherwise, as the dean, I feel guilty when a student comes to me and asks, you know, 25,000 or 50,000 money for his career development. And in that particular situation, UPSA came forward and helped the student. And I really appreciate those things. Not only that, even the many other contributions were made by the UPSA. Then before I wind up, I want to thank the office bearers of the association who served during this year for their commitment and hard work to develop this association to a better position. And I hope the office bearers who will be elected a couple of minutes later and will carry out the good work of the present committee, as well as all the members, including the past presidents, secretaries, treasurers, and the executive committee members, and all the members of the association, to support the new executive committee to bring this particular association to the level we are expecting. I mean, president explained what we want to achieve or where we want to go. Then I totally agree with the president. And then finally, once again, thanking you all for participating in this particular event. I wind up my speech by wishing a successful future for the Science Alumni Association, University of Peradeniya. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your insight and encouraging words. We are always thankful for your guidance and support that you continuously extend to the UPSA. We have invited Mrs. Shyamali Chitralekha Perera, the first Lady Survey General of Sri Lanka, to deliver the guest speech. To introduce Mrs. Shyamali Perera, I cordially invite the President, UPSA, Professor Swarna Vimalasiri.
Thank you, Tarindu. Mrs. Shyamali Chitralekha Perera. She received her secondary education from Devi Balika Vidyalaya Colombo and entered the Faculty of Science, University of Peradeniya in 1981, batch of 1980-81. And she graduated in 1983 with a second class upper division, becoming the batch top of the combination double maths and physics that year, and received the Kumaraswamy Prize for best performance in physical science. She served the Department of Physics as a temporary assistant lecturer for a period of 1 year and joined the Department of Survey as an assistant superintendent of surveys in 1985. In 1989, she moved to the Institute of Surveying and Mapping at Diyatalawa as a lecturer, and after receiving her postgraduate qualification from Institute for the Aerospace and Earth Sciences in the Netherlands, she was promoted to the post of senior lecturer at Diyatalawa Institute. During the past 2 decades, her dissemination of knowledge has got extended from Diyatalawa Survey Institute to University of Sri Jayawardenepura and Postgraduate Institute of Science at Peradeniya as a visiting lecturer. She returned back to her position of Superintendent of Surveys in 1993 and served the department at different stations at varying capacities until such time she was promoted to the post of Deputy Survey General in 2008 and subsequently to the post of Senior Deputy Survey General in 2017. She reached the topmost position, Director General of the Department of Surveys, in February 2020. I am really proud to announce that Mrs. Shamali Pereira, a product of the Faculty of Science, is the first ever lady appointed to the post of Survey General in the history of Sri Lanka. Yet, Shamali is the same batchmate I met almost 40 years back in these premises, who would laugh and shout in the same old spirit. With that personal note, I would like to cordially invite Mrs. Shamali Pereira to deliver the guest speech today. Over to you, ma'am.
To you at this very special occasion, as the first lady survey general and the 50th survey general of the country. It may be represented in the Justice Department, the department in the country. It was established by Acting Secretary to the Governor, William Boyd, on the orders of the Governor Sir Frederick North on 2nd of August 1800 in Gaul by proclamation. I do wish to share a presentation with you. Sorry for troubling. It is hard for me to find. is not here. Soonam, you can see the sharing. Present now here to my skin pain. Present now we could hear. Present now we could hear the window. One minute in which we Yes. Yeah. It's okay, no? It's okay, yeah. Sorry for disturbing. Anyway, yes, with the new technology, it's making me a bad position. I will start now again. It may be interesting to know the, you know, the history of the department. The survey department is the oldest department. So the first survey general was Mr. Joseph Bonneville, worked from 1800 to 1805. And another remarkable landmark is the appointment of the first Sinhala Survey General, appointed after the independence, Mr. N.S. Pereira, the 22nd Survey General, and his tenure was 3 years, from 1954 to 1958. You maybe know that Dr. N.M. Pereira, he was the brother of Mr. N.S. Pereira. After establishing the survey department, there were principal five surveyors who assigned to do the revenue collection, assigned to do the land survey for the purpose of revenue collection for the country. I had worked under the 16 survey generals during my 35 years of career. And I am the 15th line from Perajani alumni out of those 15 survey generals. And it is very proud to say that in front of the Perajani science faculty alumni. As Professor Vimalakiri explains, I passed out from Perajani University in 1983 and joined the survey department in 1985. Most of you were studying different departments in the science faculty and now being engaged in the different professional disciplines. I do wish to make you aware what the survey department been doing for the country since 1800 as the oldest department in the country. The work in early period had been easy paced, but the biggest obstacle being the environment hazards encountered in pioneering the work of the surveyor. You could see the immaculate work shown in the field books and plans of the early surveyors. Perhaps the surveyor who wished to make the best use of his time when venturing into the field, working from dawn to dusk, spending the rest of his working time in the survey camp, most of us known as the Kudaran. Finishing up the fine work called the preparation of plans. So, this is some historical maps you may be interested to see that prepared since 1482 till 1859. So this is the first title plan issued by the survey department on 20th August 1800 by the survey general John Bill. This is the temple of Truth Relief in Kandy. This is the Queen's Hotel in Kandy. I purposely extracted some interesting features related to the Kandy. This is the clear sheet of Sripada area. And this is the Ruwan Meli Paya in Anuradhapura. And these are the two examples of the temple title plans. So the serving is a very hard job. Even I myself had to do the surveys in jungle areas by crossing rivers from barefoot. These are some examples what I shown you, the historical information. Apart from that, the department has its national assets as the National Geodetic Control Network, topographic one-inch map series, and now in metric units. Just you can see the part of the Kandin 1 to 50,000 map. And we preserve the old survey records in hard copy and soft copy format, digital land survey data and survey plans, digital spatial data in 3D form, etc. As the surveyors have been fundamental part of the human societies, met the need for demarcating property boundaries, cadastral surveys for title registration, making maps for planning and decision making, and for social school curriculum, and many more. Advances in computer technology and with the higher standards of living demand more from survey professionals. Therefore, the department has been now changing its role towards the geo-data management to reach the national requirements. We are now taking spatial measurements such as survey controls more accurately and quickly using global navigation satellite systems. Real-time kinematic surveys, we call the RTK surveys, and ground measurements using total stations in digitally up to millimeter accuracy. It could be used by geospatial systems which need to serve the land information requirements for planners in different sectors, managers, researchers, and citizens by seamlessly integrating with other systems like e-governance, e-commerce, etc. So it may be interesting for me to tell you something for the professionals. The important points what Professor Sarna mentioned, to conclude my speech, as a survey professional and the current leader of the oldest department, these thoughts are especially for the young professionals. So the word image, has the meaning other than the visual perception and object. The I stands for innovation, M stands for mastering, A stands for authenticity, G stands for gain, and E stands for ethics. So these are the most important constants we should note as an image, because we the professionals, we have to understand and we have to live in our society to cope up by following the what the stands meant in the word image. I innovation, key for the society improvements. The leaders who change the world have always invented and innovated through their own career with new concepts. So the innovation is very much relevant for the professionals, even the students who are studying and doing the researches, all the things. The innovation is very important concept. And M stands for the mastery. That is also at most important. Committing yourself to master at whatever you do, whatever the professional you are. Devote to being the first and the most, the only the best in your own career. That actually the dean and the professor Vimalasiri also very clearly explained that. Work offers you a daily platform to discover the leader with you. The mastery is again the most important thing what we have to keep in mind. The A stands for the authenticity, the quality of being genuine and true. Have a genuine smile with your own image. So that is also very, very important, even the present day context. The G for gain, to get closer to something pursued, aim in the winning position. That is the thing, not even the students, for us in our life, we have to always to have again something, that means to aim in the winning position. E, the ethics, it is also very much relevant. Be with moral principles, never do anything that will tarnish the integrity that you will establish as a leader. Nothing is more important than being honest. So the ethically, we have to do our professional things to share with the society, to uplift the country from the current status. So as such, I do wish to conclude my speech, and I have to tell you that as the professionals, as the students, as the researchers, even the citizens of the country, we ourselves have to obey the word image to get uplift the Sri Lanka to the international level standards at this moment. So I have to thank Professor Vimalachari and the organizers for giving me this opportunity, even the online. And I have to tell you that even though the technology is so sophisticated, I also had some difficulty to share my thoughts with you, and small break was there. I apologize that also. And I do wish to wind up now. Thank you so much.
We are privileged to have a great alumnus like you as our guest speaker today. Your participation today added so much value to the event. Next, I would like to announce the recipient of Ranjit Gurge Memorial Studentships. As for the selection criteria, the nominations received from Head Department of Chemistry are Ms. Kaushalya Lakmali, for the continuation of the award for the second term. Mr. Milan Vijayasinghe, for the studentship for the ongoing academic year 2019-2020. Now I would like to invite Professor Swarna Vimalasiri to continue with the business meeting of the 11th annual general meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Lahiru. And welcome to the business meeting of the Science Alumni Association. First item in the agenda is the adoption of the minutes of the 10th AGM. And we circulated the AGM minutes to you. And that will be presented by the secretary, Dr. Dev Surendra. Yeah. Those who are here, it's inside the file. If you can just go through the minutes and inform us if there are any corrections to be made. There are three pages. Page one has got attendance and the sections, inauguration, annual general meeting, confirmation of minutes. And page two. Huh? Page two, yes.
These people are not supposed to be ordinary members, they are the ordinary members of council. They are all ordinary members. So they think that to be an ordinary member of council. Similarly,
oh, I see.
You might be an ordinary member of council.
Section 2.4, selection of office bearers, lines, second paragraph, you have mentioned that Chintaka Intika Dehena and Dimanti Uduwala were proposed as ordinary members. They are not proposed as ordinary members, they are ordinary members of the council. Okay, all of us are ordinary members.
Page three.
Mr. Chintaka, second para, right? Page 3, second para, I think Mr. Chintaka Indika here suggested, it should be suggested, no? Yeah.
A central point to connect with individual batches.
Also now in the section 2.3, statement of accounts, nowhere does it state that the accounts are adopted. It must be a statement saying that the presented the statement of accounts which was adopted by the house or something must be there, no?
Hmm? 2.3.1?
3.1. Okay, right. Thanks. Sorry.
Any other corrections, please? There are no corrections, no more corrections. Can someone please propose that the minutes are in order and get it seconded? Thank you. And the next item in the agenda is the presentation of the annual report. Of course, as we have already explained in the inaugural session, that we couldn't do much during the year. But whatever we have done and the proposals that have come up in the executive meetings will be presented to you by Dr. Tharindu Devasurendra, who is the secretary of the association.
Thank you, madam.
That again is circulated and it's there in the files, and also we have circulated it among the members, those who are joining online. You have it with you.
And there's a small correction to be made, that patron should be spelled as P-A-T-R.
P-A, yeah. You can.
Thank you, madam. As the secretary of the University of Peradeniya Science Alumni Association, today I am present. I am pleased to submit the annual report at its 11th annual general meeting, being held on Saturday, 19th of December 2020. Members of the executive committee are: patron is Professor Shaluka Kodithuwakku, president Professor Swarna Vimalasiri, vice president Professor Kalinga Bandara, honorary secretary Dr. Tharindu Devasurendra, honorary treasurer Dr. Priyanga Vijay Singha, alumni relation officer is Mr. Saumya Bandara, chairman of fundraising committee is Professor Nanda Balasuriya, chairman of the outreach committee is Dr. Chamra Jayasundara, chairman of volunteer management committee is Dr. Dimanti Udvela, and the ordinary members are Dr. Ashwini Amarasingha, Dr. Udayana Ranatunga, and Mr. Chintaka Indikada Hena. We had 6 executive committee meetings during the year under review. Next, I'm going to present the activities carried out during the period. As the first activity, we supported students to get e-learning facilities. Here, the committee received a list of students from the Dean's Faculty of Science who requested e-learning support to continue their studies during the COVID-19 lockdown period. After carefully investigating their financial situations, UPSA provided financial support of 1,000 rupees to 13 students to purchase data packages and 5,000 rupees to one student to purchase a router. As a continuation of the program, in December 2020, UPSA provided 1,000 rupees each for 9 students from the list of 13 students who have received support in the first instance. New members, during the period under review, there were 23 new alumni members join the association, and which reach the total number of memberships to 571. Ranjit Gurge Memorial Studentship. Based on the Ranjit Gurge Memorial Studentship selection criteria, Ms. Kaushalya Lakmali and Mr. IAMP Ileperuma were awarded Ranjit Gurge Memorial Studentships for the year, academic year 2018 and 2019. Further, as a continuation, Ms. Kaushalya Lakmali will receive the studentship for the second time, and Mr. Milan Vijayasingha is nominated for the award of the studentship for the ongoing academic year 2019-2020. Studentships are awarded from the interest of the fixed deposit, which was started with the kind donation received by UPSA from 1968-69 batch to initiate Ranjit Gurge Memorial Studentship. Next, I am going to present UPSA ongoing projects. First project is laptop pool project. Here, UPSA is working on creating a pool of laptops and tablets which can be provided to needy students on loan. At the second project, UPSA is working with Laugh Gas PLC for concession to the UPSA membership for their membership card. For the project UPSA Talk series, UPSA is planning to invite Dr. Manoj Alavathukottuva, Department of Fine Arts, Faculty of Arts, University of Peradeniya, to deliver an online talk to the first year students. Also, UPSA is planning to invite Professor Buddhi Marambe, Department of Crop Science, Faculty of Agriculture, University of Peradeniya, to deliver an online talk to first year students. UPSA project proposal. UPSA is in the process of preparing a list of potential projects with estimates to present to UPSA members and other alumni chapters to get their sponsorship for such projects. I greatly acknowledge the support extended by the executive committee members during the activities conducted by the association during the past year. A heartfelt gratitude goes to all the members and well wishers for their participation in UPSA activities. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Arindu. And the next item in the agenda is treasurer's report.
PLANING. So why are we putting your planning if you have not had it? So it shouldn't be here, no?
Plan for some activity. What you did during that period,
plan to start a series.
Plan.
But not to planning. Not even invited.
We have invited. Couldn't do it.
We paid them to this is just for the your information. As I said, you see this new member. During this year only 23.
Yeah.
As I said, if we somehow get this demonstrators to obtain the membership, 22 demonstrators only at the Department of Chemistry.
25 at the Department of Mathematics, right? 17 or 20 at the Department of Statistics and Computer Science. Total of 147 demonstrators per year. If you get at least 100 within 5 years, we can get a lot. I mean, last year also.
Abhini, if you think that we visiting the departments, we can do it.
We can do it in my department.
Heads. Okay.
Support of 1,000 rupees to that is to but it say
1,000 rupees each.
Yeah. Shall we move?
What we have now, laptops and tablets?
That is, sir, we are, we discussed to, I mean, get such, I mean, say, like if you have two, to give one to the UPSA so that we can give it to a needy student.
Permanent?
Yeah. No, we are not giving it to permanently two students on loan.
Room there, computer room, and we started having it, allowing them to come at night and do it. We organized that. So then we found that one of the students removed some part and put his old part in the computer. So that type of things are happening. So I just want to tell you.
For example, the Department of Chemistry, that Dr. Adarsi, she had one of the used laptop. She gave it away to a student. I mean, that's permanently. Likewise, if our members have two or more laptops, the older one can be given to a student. And then I also know that this Professor Shamaliya Besekara, I don't know from where it is initiated, and she also had this story somehow, and then she requested money, then I also contributed. That is the one of the students having a lot of financial difficulties with this e-learning, and then somehow collected money and purchased laptop and give, or something like that. As Professor Kumar said, I think the giving on loan, no guarantee that we will get back. And therefore, whatever it is, permanent loan, not the loan. Yeah.
Okay. So the next item in the agenda is treasurer's report, and those who are joining online, of course, I mean, if there is an issue, you can raise your hand or you can place your question in the chat box, and any other matters, we will open the forum for discussion. So Dr. Priyanka will be presenting the treasurer's report.
Yeah. Okay, good evening, everybody. So I'm going to present the income and expenditure account for the period of October 1st, 2019 to September 30th, 2020. First, the income from new membership fees, we got 19,000 rupees, and selling t-shirts, 10,400 rupees, and selling ties, 20,000 rupees, selling mugs, 6,500 rupees, and the AGM registration held last February, 22,000 rupees, and the interest received, 90,334 rupees and 77 cents. And the donations for the AGM, 7,100 rupees. So the total come to the income, total income was 175,334 rupees and 77 cents. Moving on to the expenditure. We purchased a steel cupboard for UPSA for 29,555 rupees. And the expenses for the annual general meeting, 85,300 rupees. And Ranjit Guruge Memorial Studentship, 30,000 rupees. Actually, we increased that from 20,000 from last year to 30,000 this time because we are getting a decent interest. And that means 10,000 from 10,000 to 15,000 per head. And as Dr. Tarun explained, for giving that financial assistance for online learning to buy data with 18,000 rupees. And that brings us to the total expenditure of 162,855 rupees. So this brings to income of expenditure for the period, 12,479 rupees and 77 cents. Can you scroll to the next page here? And now if we bring it forward, the income of expenditure, under equity and liabilities, so you can see that income of expenditure 12,479 rupees and 77 cents, and we had accumulated fund from the last year 1,645,438 rupees and 46 cents. So altogether, that gives us the total equity of 1,657,918 rupees and 23 cents. And since we didn't have any liabilities, all these become our assets, and which represented in one in at the bank as well as in cash in hand. First, cash in hand 77,840 rupees and 67 cents, and the cash or the money at bank 1,580,077 rupees and 56 cents. And under note one, I have given you a breakdown of that amount, the money at the bank. If you scroll down, yeah. So here, note one, in our Bank of Ceylon current account, we have 85,774 rupees and 36 cents. And in the People's Bank savings account, 244,303 rupees and 20 cents. And the People's Bank fixed deposit, we used to have 650,000 rupees. And finally, you can see the People's Bank's fixed deposit, the one that we opened, for 600,000 rupees, and which was a suggestion last time from the AGM, and we were able to do that. And okay, so that's the end of the financial report. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank our assistant Bursa, Ms. Chaturani, wonderful person. She helped a lot going through each and every receipt and every transaction, all the bank balances. And with that, I'll conclude. Thank you.
Comments, and if there are anything to be corrected.
Yeah, from 10, now 5.5. Correct, 10.5. Now it's 5.5.
What are you going to do? What is your strategy? What are you going to do?
Thirty thousand. No. Each year, two persons. So 15,000 each.
Each.
We calculated it. We are okay. No, sir. A person who gets in the third year will get it in the fourth year, and the fourth year will get another new one from the third year. So we calculate, even if it is at 5%, we are okay. We can manage. Yeah. So that's what we counted, and we expect it will not go down, not go below 5%. So that's what the economics people say. Eighty percent. Capital has to grow. Yeah. Yeah, it's calculated to 80% of the interest at 5% rate. Still, we are okay.
T-shirt selling or whatever, mug selling, can't you say sale of mugs and sale of T-shirts?
Me
And we are not probably in the dinner.
No dinner today.
No, we are
yet. That I sponsored, so no problem. Any comments from the online participants? Already four people. If there are no more corrections, can we take this in order?
You have the fixed deposit. We like to see how it grow. For example, 650,000 rupees may be the initial deposited money. After 5-6 years, maybe now the value is different. As I already got to know, interest is calculated and represent in some other place. Better to represent the present value of the fixed deposit annually. Is it difficult? Because you have the statement, better to include the last statement value. Then we can see, because otherwise every year it is only 650,000. If you are taking that interest to some other thing,
it was.
That is the interest received.
Yeah, so we have not added that to this one. We can do that.
There
is a single passbook.
Single passbook, so. And we can see. It's not just 650. Yeah. So it's keep adding. Yeah.
And we can see the growth.
Yes.
So with that comment, I can propose the budget.
Answer propose karain and calling second karaki aliya. It's okay. And the next item in the agenda is election of new office bearers. We requested nominations, but we did not receive any nominations. So what we did was we wanted to have the same committee, but according to the constitution, we will have to. I mean, some of us have completed the time that is assigned. So, therefore, I will read out what the executive committee proposed for the office bearers 2021. The president, immediate past president, and the vice president do have 3 years of term. So, therefore, we have to remain. Myself, Professor Vimalasiri, as the president. Professor Kalinga Bandar as the Vice President and Professor HMN Bandar as the immediate past President. And Dr. Tarindu Deva Surendra's term is 2 years. He has served only one term, so therefore we requested him to remain as the Secretary of the Association. And what we did was, we requested the outgoing members to propose a person in their place. So accordingly, Treasurer, Dr. Priyanka Vijayasinghe proposed the name of Dr. Buddhi Nanayakkara, which was seconded by Professor Salukakodi Tuakku. And the alumni relations officer has to be proposed by the Dean of the faculty. So accordingly, Professor Salukakodi Tuakku proposed the name of Dr. Prabhat Gunatilaka. Is he doctor or mister? And seconded by Dr. Ashwini Amarasinghe. As for the chairperson fundraising committee, Mr. Saumya Bandara proposed Mr. Chintaka Indigada Hena, which was seconded by Dr. Tarindu Deva Surendra. And chairperson outreach committee, Professor Vimalasiri proposed Dr. Manjula Vijayasinghe, and seconded by Dr. Dimanti Uduvela. Chairperson Volunteer Management Committee, Professor Nandabala Surya proposed the name of Dr. Prasanna Dharmapriya, seconded by Dr. Ashwini Amarasinghe. And for the three ordinary members of the council, since we want Dr. Priyanka Vijayasinghe to be here as the outgoing treasurer, his name was proposed by Dr. Tarindu Deva Surendra and seconded by Dr. Dimanti Uduela. And Professor Vimalasiri proposed Dr. Subhashini Gunatilaka, seconded by Dr. Tarindu Deva Surendra. And Mr. Chintaka Indikadahena proposed the name of Mr. Senrat Tekanayaka, proposed by Professor Vimalasiri. So accordingly, the president will be Professor S. Vimalasiri, and the vice president is Professor Kalinga Bandara. Immediate past president is Professor H.M.N. Bandara. Honorary secretary, Dr. Tharindu Deva Surendra. Honorary treasurer, Dr. Buddhi Nanayakara. Alumni relations officer, Mr. Prabhat Gunatilaka. Chairperson fundraising committee, Mr. Chintaka Indikadahena. Chairperson outreach committee, Dr. Manjula Vijayasinghe. Chairperson volunteer management committee, Dr. Prasanna Dharmapriya. Ordinary members of the council, Dr. Priyanga Vijayasinghe, Dr. Subhashini Gunatilaka, and Mr. Senrat Tekanayaka. That is the total council for the next year. And now we have the discussion. Any other matters in the agenda? So they. Those who are joining online also can participate, and we need to discuss as to what we are, what we should be doing in the coming year. So proposals are welcome.
This is just a comment about the felicitation of our senior members. Do they have some words to say that?
Ah, yeah. Sorry, I forgot to inform about. In fact, each year we felicitate. Senior academics who have served the faculty for long years, but this year, I mean, since we are having this AGM with a limited number of participants and many online, we thought it's not nice, so we will have a separate event once the situation gets better with members attending and probably a day function with a lunch. So that's our plan. I think it will improve. We will try. No trip by Zoom. Online trip. Now this membership thing we will have to somehow push.
Sorry, I just need to talk to all my Dutch friends to get to their budget.
It is there, no?
It is there.
No, we're in the online thing. Because we have the online application now, not the paper
application. Yeah. So the online application can be. Yes.
No, I tried. You can't feel it.
No, madam, that is the paper application. No, madam. Uh-huh. We're talking about the PDF.
You mean there is a link? Yes. I didn't.
A Google check form?
Uh-huh.
So. That can be published on Facebook as well, on the UPSA Facebook page and their website. They have to pay, they have to do the usual bank transfer, and then they have to attach the deposit slip.
Anyway, they have to go to a bank. That is the problem. We don't have a gate here. So if we send the money to the university, that is the end of it. So directly to our account?
Download the e-receipt and email it to
plus.
Yeah.
But problem is this foreign people, right? Mm-hmm. Foreign people, I'm still not sure. Still, but that would be foreign transfer, no, anyway. You were just saying the people can't like England, if there's someone, our person, having the people bank account here and there, I'm still not sure whether they can transfer money from here to Abhava. That is the payment that they have to pay there, not here. Our banks don't charge. It is the payment of transaction from there to here. They even if they do it through this Zoom thing, they charge 5.5. The bad thing is, check with our own bank. We have $100, and they had sent me a check. I deposited it. Finally, I got only 60.
Terrible.
Yeah, I tell you that my wife gets a monthly payment for her pension, and we deposit every month, and they don't have 1 cent. We are payment, we are prudent customers. $100, and this is no problem.
Oh, maybe they may have charged from that end.
No, no, they can't. No, no.
No, what I suggest is that they have someone here, no? I am proposing that they have someone here in Sri Lanka. Why can't they pay this 1,000 rupees? If they want a transcript, they will easily ask the parent or a brother or a friend to come and pay 750. Why can't they do the same for this?
They are ready to sit there for a day. That was a
kind of thing, no? Yeah. So.
There are some pictures from the.
Yeah, chat box.
What are they?
PayPal.
You cannot receive money from here. No.
Asking about PayPal.
PayPal.
No.
PayPal.
Many people can get together and send one check. So that is another thing that I proposed.
To encourage this foreign people, having the at the association, they must bear the whatever the reduction by the banks are. even though your membership fee is 1,000, even we received 800, we should accept it. Transaction store, they have paid 1,000. Due to this foreign transaction, we lose 200.
Everybody agrees on that, then.
Sir?
$100
for one student. No, sir. ₹1,000.
Same amount.
Don't know whether the AUP has some difference. We don't. No, not from us, sir.
Yes, answer.
Maybe AUP, I don't know. AUP get the hint that the
matter. That's why most people don't join.
If it is
$1,000,
Tiano, sir, himika. There is a clause here. Yes, the association may have only life membership, and the fee shall be ₹1,000 for locally resident members and US$50 for foreign members. But foreign members, can foreign citizens rent by? The students are not foreign citizens.
But who is going to come? But I'm pretty sure when they wrote this, they had in mind like anybody who left Sri Lanka for him. I think.
So again, the money hand only. $50. No. Did you have it in your mind? I mean, those who are residing with the visa or whatever. Say, if the citizens, it's okay. I mean, 50 is nothing for the citizen.
Can read it.
What it says, excuse the me? Association may have only life membership, and the fee shall be ₹1,000 for locally resident members and US$50 for foreign members. Foreign residents. But now I can't do this. No, I can't do the change. I will cross it and write and keep.
There is a
question on the chat asking for, I'm asking whether there is a possibility of having a member each from each batch, a representative in UPSA. One thing we can do is that we can get people, such people, to the Alumni Relations Committee, the subcommittee of UPSA.
What does mean by each batch?
Each batch is...
present batch or present four batches or all the batch of batches. That should be clear to
you. No, but
yeah, but no.
Life membership fee is ₹1,000 for
life membership.
It is life membership. ₹1,000.
Yes, correct.
Yeah. Any other suggestions? If not, to end the business meeting, I kindly request Dr. Tharindu Deva Surendra to propose vote of thanks.
Thank you, madam. The Dean, Professor Shaluka Kodithwakku, President of UPSA, Professor Swarna Vimalasiri, special invitees, executive committee members, dear members of UPSA, and ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the executive committee, first and most, I would like to convey my gratitude to our guest speaker, Mrs. Shamali Pereira, for accepting our invitation and joining with us virtually at this great occasion. We are privileged to have a great alumnus like you as our guest today, and your presence made this event an unforgettable one. And thank you, madam, for your inspiring talk. I thank the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Shaluka Kodithwakku, for the great strength he has always been to the association. We thank Dr. Varuni Senaviratna, the head of the Department of Physics, and her staff for arranging the venue for the virtual AGM and for the technical support. Also, I would like to thank Professor HMTGA Pitavada, the director of PGIS, and Dr. Rekha De Silva, the head of the Department of Mathematics, for providing technical equipment for the virtual AGM setup. I wish to specially thank Mr. Lahiru Ekanayaka, Lecturer Probationary Computer Unit, and Mr. C.U. Vadasingha, Technical Officer, Department of Physics, for their untiring work throughout last few days to get the virtual AGM's technical setup established. I also wish to thank all the academic and non-academic staff members who helped us in different ways to make today's event a success. I wish to appreciate the support extended by the Chief Medical Officer and Public Health Inspector of the university for providing guidance to hold this event at this difficult situation in the country. I appreciate the continuous support extended by all EXCO members during the years and also in preparation for the AGM. You all had been great strength to the association. Last but not least, I thank all of you, our valuable membership, who are present here today and for supporting the association in numerous ways. Without you, we would not have succeeded as a team. I thank everybody who have helped immensely to make the AGM a success, and I hope you will continue support the association the best you can in the years ahead. Thank you for it. Thank you.
Right, thank you.